Hello there, ladies and gentlemen, thrill seekers of all ages. My name is Coaster Chal, and welcome to Coaster Chal, the YouTube channel. Hello there, ladies and gentlemen, thrill seekers of all ages. Coaster Chal here, Doncaster born, but built for theme parks, and welcome to a Theme Park Newsroom update, where today we've got some big news from Phantasialand. It's been approved, the first of the two major hurdles in the long-term development and expansion of the Phantasialand theme park. It's just been announced this evening. That's why I'm bringing this video out to you late at night, going into the day after. If you're watching this on the Wednesday around midnight or so, hello. If you're watching this on the Thursday morning, good morning. Sorry about the early wake-up call, but Phantasialand's long-term application for expansion may have just got its first seal of approval. Now, before we get started, guys, make sure you do like the video if you loved it. Comment down below your thoughts and opinions. Subscribe if you are new around here. Click the notification bell so you don't miss a YouTube video. Also, guys, check the description down below for social media links and the Google Forms link where you behind the camera can submit your own video ideas. This is really exciting, this update. This is really exciting. If you're a football fan, this is like your local League One club getting a massive takeover to become one of the richest football clubs in the world. This is what it's like for theme parks. This is Phantasialand getting a massive expansion site, or on the step, one more step to getting this expansion site. So let's go into details about what's happening. So this is a significant win for Phantasialand in their decades of fighting for an expansion. The NRW state government has at last agreed to sell the park to the land west of the park, which has been subject to the last 10 years of expansion debate. However, before celebrating a bit too early, with the final hurdle, which is the local council to approve the planning. But the current council is anti-expansion, so they'll probably need to wait until the next election in a few years to see if there's a change in parties. But this is nevertheless a big step forward towards expansion and the most significant development in 20 years. Now, the official statement reads as follows. Good news for Brule, good news for Phantasialand. The NRW cabinet today decided to sell the land owned to the state, which Phantasialand needs for the urgently needed expansion to the amusement park by swapping land. Our thanks go to the FDP state parliament members of the Rhine-Erft-Christ Ralph Bombis and the Rhine state Chris John Frinnick, who campaigned for it on the FDP side. Now the ball is back with us in Brule. It'll be interesting to see how the parliamentary groups in the council will position themselves in this regard. Now, of course, the land in question. The Phantasialand owner, Robert Loftonhart, spoke to the parks about the park's master plan in an interview with Park World magazine back in 2014 at the opening of Chappas. Hopefully his hope that they get it in 2014 didn't work out, but there is a relieved man, I'm sure. So obviously you can see this Google Maps image on your screen right now. This is where it is. This is literally just opposite where Temple of the Crazy Bats, Temple of the Nighthawk, sorry, with the Crazy Bats VR is. This is literally opposite that. And it's this massive piece of land. This land has been subject to 10 years of debate. 10 years of debate. It's amazing. And I feel like this is a really promising step forward. So now let's share my thoughts on what exactly has happened. There we are, ladies and gentlemen, thrill seekers of all ages. That is speaking about Phantasialand's long-term expansion debate. We've hit a major milestone tonight. It's coming. One step to go. Brule have got to decide. The council have got to decide yes or no. And even though they're anti-expansion, this is a huge step forward in the last 10, 20 years of Phantasialand. Huge, huge yes towards Phantasialand. And I really can't wait for this. The potential of this plot of land is absolutely amazing. Think of the themed areas that Phantasialand have done in recent years. The Rookburgh area where Fly, the Vekoma Flying Coaster is. Klugheim, where Taran and Rake are located. I feel like Phantasialand are just getting their feet under the table now. And I think it's only a matter of time before we see Brule in the next few years, the Brule Council, give it the final yes. And I've got a gut feeling of confidence they're going to give it the final yes. So I really think this is a big yes for Phantasialand and a huge step forward for their long-term future. So big up to everyone involved in that decision. You've made the right decision, in my opinion. Phantasialand is arguably the best theme park in the world, arguably one of the best in Europe. And I feel like Phantasialand is going to make major, major strides forward. I would like to now, off the back of this, if they give this the final yes in the next few years as well, this will help even more. But I feel like I need to go to Phantasialand before this expansion even thinks about kicking off. Like, if, let's say, I go before they get the final yes, then that'd be amazing. If they say no, then I visit Phantasialand anyway. But imagine seeing Phantasialand like now and then 10 or 15, 20 years from now with the massive expansion in place. That would be amazing. But there we are. So thank you very much, guys, for watching this video. Make sure you do like, comment, subscribe. And for now, my name is Coach Chell. Keep it on the coast of life. And I'll see you guys in the next video very, very soon. Take care, guys. Have a Phantasia-tastic day.